So, as we all know, Islands just had a new Halloween update. And I'm going to show you through all the things. So, to get to the Halloween update, you are going to have to come here and take a left over here and just walk straight. I would recommend some chilies because it's much more helpful. And see, Zombie Cletus right there. That's the new boss. So, and to get that, once you kill him, you're going to get this. Zombie Cletus tokens, right? You're going to get this right here. So what you do is you first kill the boss. This is what the boss will look like. This right here is one of the new items, the Reaper's Scythe. You can just kill the boss, you know, defend, protect. And then once you kill him, you can come here. You'll get these tokens. There's a new shop, all of this, you can use your money on it. What you mainly want to buy is this and this with your tokens. I'm just gonna buy, let's say, four, right? See, now I have the new cauldrons. This is what you can get from killing the boss. And once you kill the boss, you also get zombie tokens, which, like I just did, you can get from there. So, if you were to go back home, right, let's just first dive in here. You can open it to get the new rewards. And what the new rewards are I'm going to show you in a bit, the new scythe, like I showed you, a crossbow, a new crossbow. So here, like this scythe, new scythe. These are the new ghost things. This is the happy ghost, surprise ghost, angry ghost. I'll just show you. Good. So surprise ghost, an evil ghost, happy ghost, and a group of ghosts. These are the group of ghosts, which is basically all three of them into one. So, if I go here, these are all my open cauldrons that I try to get. You can place them down, and then if you click F, you will open them. And you have a chance of getting, like I showed you, the ghost, the new Reaper's Scythe, a Zombie Cletus tokens, and the new crossbow. There's a new crossbow, which is very, very cool. Very cool. And you can also get a trophy. Something new you'll see, this icon right here. If you go right here, my mounts, they added new brooms, which gives you 65% for the witches, 65% movement for the witches broom, and 50% for the regular broom. This right here, this is the quest to get the witches broom, that you'll have to come here and find it. And for the other one, for the regular one, it's this one that you're going to have to get just for the regular one. So for the witch's broom, which is, I'm just going to say, you want to get it, you're going to have to kill one infernal dragon, two void serpents, five zombie Cletus, which isn't so hard, slime king, core, wizard boss, slime queen, and phantom. You should probably, to get all of it, you should probably get level 70, because that's when you get be able to get all of these things. Fanhorn, you're going to have to do some quests, but that shouldn't be too hard. Like, you're going to need you're going to have to do some things, get some pancakes, make, like, tons of pancakes. This is for the Fanhorn. And, yeah, really. So, I will show you what it will look like to get the broom. So, you'll get gum here, underworld, that's what I'm trying to do at least. Which hopefully isn't too hard. I recommend that you grab some like chili peppers, or like chili peppers, and for food, I recommend berry pancakes because they heal for 50, which is pretty good. The Reaper's Scythe, which is actually the best heavy melee weapon. Oh, and I just remembered, you cannot actually trade. As you see here, it says not tradable. All of the Halloween items will be tradable after the event, and the event is going to be for 3 entire weeks. So you're going to have a lot of time to get all of your things. So as you see, it deals slashing void damage, which is very, very useful because it's a void item. So it's like the Bane, if I have it. Nope, I do not have it on me. But it's like the Serpent's Bane, but it's actually better by, funny enough, 3 damage, which is crazy. So I don't think anyone will be able to spawn the Inferno Dragon, so what we can do is we can find some serpents, void serpents, and then we'll get through all the tests. I will make a separate video on how to get to all of the, how to kill all of the mobs and bosses and what you need to kill, but later on that will be another video. So you're gonna have to come here, Desert Island. Yep. They've included some new a wooden mallet and a granite mallet, so that's really useful for some starter people, but it is quite like hefty. You need like 40 wood and or 40 pieces of granite, which is crazy. So I already done Baja, so I'm gonna need to come here and go over this portal to get to the Void Islands. See Void Islands. And we will be very, very soon. My advice is for killing this, as you see here. No, here. Void potions, you should take this, because it is very much more useful for these smoke effects. So I'll just take one for 30 seconds, but it's okay. Look, see, normally you would take damage, but see, I just went through and I didn't take it. I took damage, but not as much as I would normally. I must say, the best weapon, as you see here, the Static Scepter, that's probably for sure the best weapon for the new zombie Cletus, because it's like, unless you want to lag out the server, see, Floydhound, that's something you're gonna need to kill. Unless you want to like lag out the entire server, you should probably use it because it deals consistent damage, and it, overall it's just really, really good. What I'm trying to do it right now is I'm actually picking up some void void parasites, because it is much more useful, because you can get void seeds, which is like pretty, it's like worth a lot. It's like around 1 million, so that's pretty good. So now we are getting to a void serpent. To get to the void serpent, you have to go through this mouth. From like all the way here, go what I did through here, and the way I just did 3 count is by shift and P. You need to have pro pass or VIP pass, so thought that could be a little help. Get a little help. Okay, so see, I would also recommend to get some like things like to help boost your luck chance, like blueberry cookies or dragon rolls. Blueberry cookies are initially better because it's much cheaper and you don't have to spend a lot of time getting it. It's just overall better, I must say. Because it's like, because it doesn't last for as long, but it for sure does help a lot more. So, as we are, we're killing it. Oh, I should probably take some potions, because it is much more helpful. For sure, used for damage, like, starfruit cake. I don't have any on me, but it is for sure much more useful. It's way, way useful that time. Like, see, 50, it's really, really good for, it's much better to use sweet pancakes, but to only use the fanhorn pancakes when you're gonna kill fanhorn, which is much more useful. Because then you have a chance to get antler's helmet or the antler's shield, which is very, very, like, a small chance, but it's very, very useful in the long run, because you can sell it for, like 14 million or something, but it is a grind, I must say. Okay, we gotta find the Void Serpent. He is low, but not low enough, so I'll just wait till the last second until using your blueberry cookie. So Void Serpent's gonna appear soon. There. Now I'm gonna eat my cookie. See, is it only, you can't see clearly, but it says 30% reward luck in combat. So that's when you, after you kill it. So, and it's only for 1 minute. It says 50 seconds now because I've used it. But it is for sure, very, very useful. I will tell you that. Yeah. I have to kill 2 Void Serpents, which is kind of very annoying, but come on. Ender. Oh my god, the lag. There we go. We did not get the kill for the Void Serpent, which sucks, for sure. But I will be grinding to get to the, new mount. So, until then, see ya, and I would very much appreciate if you could hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on those notifications for when I post another video. And I am very sorry that I haven't been uploading in a while. Well, I hope you have a nice day.